you guys, welcome to Scriberry and Family. So today I just want to post about my update. Today makes 6 weeks and I want to give an update of my 6 weeks. So when I weighed in, my weight was 292 pounds at surgery date. Today I am 266. So I lost 26 pounds in 6 weeks. Now, I did stall for 3 of those weeks. And stalling is when you don't lose no weight at all. I believe that your body is trying to figure out what's going on. And it's just at a standstill. Plus, I was not getting all my fluids in. I was not getting all my protein in. I was not doing everything that I needed to do in order to lose the weight, because this is all new to me. So I didn't know how and what I needed to do, but now I do know. Now I'm aware, I'm much better at it. So all last week I was able to get my fluids in, my proteins in, my protein bars. I've been doing everything that I needed to do. Plus I just started back working. So let's go to the beginning. Anytime I would eat regular food, I would always bring it back up, and I didn't know why. So I found out that even though my stomach went from a size of a football to a size of a thumb, I still have gas in that pouch. So when you have gas in there and you're trying to eat, the food that you eat, it sits on top of that gas. And of course, it can't go down, so it's only going to come back up. So now what I do is before I eat anything, I take me a gasset or Tom, or I eat or drink something warm before I decide to have a meal. Now think about it. When you go to Benihana's, the first thing they do is give you a broth soup, a warm soup to put on your stomach first. That actually relieves all the gas that's in your stomach and prepare you for the food that you're about to eat. So that's what I have to do. And if you had this surgery and you find yourself constantly vomiting and not keeping your food down, just try it. Even if you just drink warm water, I don't know if that'll be tasteful for you, but it will also help. Gassets, Toms, or something warm on your stomach before you have a meal. It works. You're able to get the food down. Everything is much better. Now that I got past that stage, I'm good. I do notice that when I get full, my nose start running. I get hiccups. I go to passing gas. And listen, them be some solid gas passes, okay? So you don't got to make an announcement. Sometimes you can't run to the bathroom right quick, because as you going to the bathroom, that shit coming out. So it's following you through the house. So sometimes it's just better to let it out and be done with it. Somebody smell it, you act like it's, you smell it too. Y'all smell that? Y'all smell that too. Y'all, who did that? Point the finger at somebody else. It is what it is, because you're going to have a lot of passing gas. Keep in mind you have gas in your stomach. Every time you talk, air is going in your body, you're gonna keep gas on your stomach. It's not a type of gas that's hurting constantly. No, my stomach doesn't hurt, but it will prevent you from getting your fluids down and your food down. You feel like you're full when you're not, but your body will tell you when you're full. When your nose start running, when you get them hiccups, you're gonna know, okay, I had enough. I'm full. That's it for the day. Other things is I can't eat nothing spicy at all. Anything spicy, it doesn't matter, gas on my stomach or not, my body just not agreeing with spicy food. So automatically that's coming back up. All spicy foods coming back up. So what I've been doing is I have me a shake in the morning, and then I have me a protein bar for snack. And then I have a shake for lunch. And then I have another protein bar. And then sometimes I have a shake for dinner. Or sometimes I might try to put something on my stomach. But it's small portions. Like small portions. All right, when I say small portions, this is a normal plate size. This is a normal size of a plate. This is the plate you're used to eating out of. This is the plate you put your food on and you sit and eat. You can't use this plate no more. You're better off using this. You see that? Big difference. Now you're gonna put your food on here. Mind you, if you wanna fill this up, go right ahead. Cause now you finna waste food. Cause you're not gonna eat all that food that you put on this plate anyway. So you can fill it up if you want to. I'd rather you fill this up than fill this up. Because now you're throwing away way, way, way too much food. We went from here to here. That's the change. So sometimes our eyes are bigger than our stomach. We got to think about it. This is what our stomach can hold. Not this anymore. What I've been doing is I've been buying food and I find myself just wasting money because I can't even eat all the food that I buy. And it's like, it makes no sense to be wasting money. So it's better if I allow my children to buy food and I eat off they food. So when it comes to like the wingless chicken, I can have two of those and maybe three French fries. And I'm done. Is it satisfying? No. It make you don't want it. Like, why even waste my time? Going to the doctor and I ain't have nothing on my stomach. I was like, let me get me a kid's meal. Went to Wendy's and got a kid's meal. Paid $4 and some change. First of all, kid's meals went too high. When my kids was little, kid's meals was 99 cents. Then my kids, they was like $1.99. So it was like $2.14 for a kid's meal. We talking $4, and I think I paid $4.40 for that kid's meal. I could not eat the bread anyway, so I take the bread off. The meat just as thin as hell. Two bites of the meat, two of the French fries, I was done. It's not satisfying, so why waste my time? Why waste my money on something that I'm not gonna eat and enjoy? So I'm done with that. I had the burger after the surgery. I don't want it anymore. I don't no longer have the urge for the burgers anymore. And that's another thing that surgery will do. It will have you don't have the urge for certain things anymore because it's unsatisfying. You're not getting satisfied anymore. So why even take the time and buy it or play with yourself or tease yourself with it when you're not gonna be satisfied with it. When it comes to the shake, this is Ensure, and it got 30 grams of protein. This is a vanilla flavor. It's really good, I like it. Give you a coffee taste. If you drink coffee or you like coffee, this would be perfect for you if you're a coffee drinker. I'm not a coffee drinker, so I didn't like the way this tastes at all. This is the chocolate. Now, this remind me of the chocolate frosty from Wendy's. That Wendy's frosty, this will put you in the mindset, especially if you put it in the freezer for a little bit. Oh man, it's like you having a whole frosty from Wendy's. This one here is a cookie and cream. Now let me tell you something. I think I told y'all before, when I get stressed out or I start feeling bad, I love to go get me a milkshake. Especially cookie and cream milkshake, my favorite. This puts you in the mind of that milkshake. It don't even got no chunks in it, but you can taste the cream and the cookie in this. Like, this is so addictive. This is my go-to. But see, I don't drink them as much because this is like a reward for myself. I reward myself with the cookie and cream. This thing so good. Oh my gosh, you guys have to try it. It is delicious. Now, I do eat applesauce and Jell-O. I did the popsicles, sugar-free popsicles. To be honest, I'm over the popsicles. I'm over the sugar-free. You're going to quickly get tired of some of this stuff. Like 26 pounds in 6 weeks is not a lot. You're going to hear a lot of people lost way more than that. In 6 weeks, they down 40 pounds. You know what I'm saying? Everybody body is different. My body ain't like your body. Your body is not like my body. So I'm not concerned about what nobody else is doing with their weight. I don't know. Only thing I'm concerned about is what I'm doing with my weight. That's the only thing that concerns me. What's happening with me? Nothing with nobody else. I can see the difference in me. Nobody else don't have to see it. I can see it. I can see the difference in the way my clothes fit, even the way my bra fit. I can pull my bra all the way down to the bottom. I never been able to do that. Instead of me having two hands full, I got a hand and a half now. You know what I'm saying? So I see it. I see the slimness within my stomach area makes me look longer. I see how my clothes fit different. I actually brought a large shorts and large shirt from Target over the weekend that I wouldn't dare try to put on a large. I always get 2X. So I can see that the weight is going down on me. Nobody else don't need to see it, long as I see it. And it's going slow, just how I want it to go. Because the faster you lose weight, the faster you have so much skin, loose skin hanging. I want to lose mine slow. I want to take my time and lose the weight. I don't want that dramatic drop out of nowhere. Because then I ain't going to have any little pretty cheekbones no more and stuff. It just drop all the way down like that. So I would tell you this. When I went to my doctor's appointment after 4 weeks, she took me off my diabetes medication and my high blood pressure medication. I no longer has to take any of that. I no longer have symptoms of diabetes. Like, I don't be thirsty. I don't feel the shakes where I need something sweet to drink. I need peppermint. Like, I don't have those feelings at all. No more. They are gone. How? I don't know. I mean, I'm not a scientist. I don't know. All I know is that I'm no longer using that big old stomach where everything go through and go through your blood cycle. I'm using a stomach of the size of a thumb where, obviously, to me, it must be more healthier because it made my body healthier. So, I love the surgery that I got. Do I have any regrets currently? No, there's nothing to regret right now. Even when I was vomiting, it wasn't nothing that I regret. It just let me know this: my body is not taking this food. I can't eat this type of stuff. I did go and get Taco Bell. I can't eat the soft tacos. That's all I ever ate soft. I never ate hard tacos, but now I got to get hard tacos. The reason I do the Taco Bell, I know it's not good, and that's ground beef, probably ain't even all the way ground beef, but it helps me go to the bathroom on my own, because if I don't use that, then I have to drink this tea to go to the bathroom, and I'm tired of putting that tea in my body. I just want my body to do what it normally would do and go to the bathroom on its own. The tea that I drink, it is called Smooth Move Tea. This is a peppermint flavor. They have other flavors that's in the store. This is a peppermint flavor. And to be honest with you, it does not taste bad. I put a sugar substitute in it and I drink it. But I don't want to rely on this. I really want my body to do what it normally would do. And since the surgery, it hasn't been doing what it normally would do. But I noticed that when I took my son to go get taco and I ate some of his stuff, it made me go to the bathroom. So every now and then, I go get me a hard taco so I can eat the bottom piece only, because I can't eat all of that hard shell. At the bottom, it don't even be hard because of the meat and the cheese in there. So I eat that bottom piece, give it a few hours, and I'm in the bathroom passing it like it's normal. So everybody pass from different things. Some people can drink milk and they pass some, you know, it's different. So that works for me, and that's why I do it. So hey, that's what it is. They want you to drink fluid, 64 ounces of fluid. It doesn't say 64 ounces of water. It says 64 ounces of fluid. So when I drink a shake, these shakes is 11 ounces by itself. So that I have to count my ounces when I drink these. So when I drink one for breakfast and one for lunch, that's 22 ounces already. Now with my water, I go ahead, I can drink that. Water, I can drink Gatorade, Powerade, Crystal Light, but I make sure I keep count of how much I drink. So therefore, I know if I reach my fluid for the day. Now, in the beginning, in order for me to know how much I'm drinking, I purchased these cups that has the measurement. Now, I got these cups from Amazon. As you can see, this cup go up to 8 ounces. So, depending on what you pour on there, you can pour how much you want. If you only want to drink 4 ounces or so, you do that, and then you go ahead and drink it. Now, I do use straws. I do not take it to the head. I use straws for everything that I drink. Other than that, I've been walking. I did a lot of walking, and now I got a personal trainer now. And last week was my first week working out with him, and I ain't gonna lie, he don't play. Like, he don't not play. Anything you do, he want at least 100 reps, 150 reps, 300 reps of that same thing. And when I tell you, when you're done, you're feeling good. But once you lay down and relax, oh man, I had my butt. I did 100 squats. Oh man, when I tell you my ass was hurting, the bone in my ass. Then he had me do 100 sit-ups. Whew. Listen, he ain't killing me, but I haven't moved these muscles in a long time. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I haven't had to move them in a long time. I've been carrying on a lot of weight. So my fat been high in my muscles. So to get out there and be pumping these muscles and moving these muscles out of nowhere, of course I'm going to be sore. My body's going to be sore. And when my body's sore, I be resting my ass off, because guess what? That shit hurt. I ain't going to lie. So, with that being said, I'm going to continue to work out. I'm not going to give up. He's very nice. Like, he tell you to do it and you just do it. You know what I'm saying? He's very motivated, and he don't rush you to do it. He just want to make sure you do it. And so, I'm going to continue to work out. And I know with working out, that's going to also help with my weight. So, my thing is, my weight could possibly be lower than what it is. Being that I be working out, you build muscle when you work out, and muscles weigh more than fat does. So where my weight is saying 266 pounds, I can actually be 260. I know I'm pushing it, but anything possible. You never know. You just never know. Going to a party this weekend, so I will be posting pictures in my dress. So for my birthday, I had to buy a size 18 dress. And my birthday was in July. So we're talking 6 months ago. I was in an 18 dress. And for this party, I brought an extra large dress. And I know I was pushing it a little bit. I'm like, you know, should I get an extra large? Because you never know. But I got an extra large dress from Fashion Nova. And I'm able to fit that dress with no problem. Actually, it feels like it's a little bit too big. So we'll see by the end of this week how much weight I do drop. Hopefully, any more weight that I do drop help me look better in the dress and don't make the dress look too big for me. Then I have to find somebody to try to take it in. So hopefully I gotta do all that. This is my update. Like, I'm good. It's a lifestyle change. This is not an easy thing. So don't let nobody come to you and be like, oh, you did it the easy way by doing surgery. Doing surgery is not an easier way of doing it. You still have to watch what you eat. You have to eat smaller portions. You have to constantly eat. You need to eat breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks in between, and drink your fluids also. So you still have to eat a certain way. You understand? Your stomach only gonna hold so much. So a lot of times you're not satisfied with what you had, but you have no other choice but to get satisfied, because you can't have nothing else. So, this is my 6 week update. I hope you enjoy my conversation. Anything that I'm missing, any questions you guys may have, please write me. I can answer your questions please don't be afraid to ask me anything. I'm not charging people to answer questions. If you want to know about my doctor, what's her address, what's her phone number, so you can get on the plan with her. If you got Medicaid, they do accept Medicaid, and Medicaid is paying for this as long as it's medical needed. With your BMI have to be, I think, 30 and higher or something like that. And if your BMI is up there, then guess what? You can get this surgery. And it doesn't take a long time. So don't listen to people when they say, oh, it took 3 months, it takes 6 months. No, it does not. This surgery, all of this process can be done within 6 weeks. And you've been had your surgery and on to your new lifestyle. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoy everything that I talked about. I hope I covered everything. I'm not sure. Again, it's been 6 weeks. So much been going on. But if you have any questions, please DM me, write me. I will answer all questions. Thank you very much. And I'll be back another 6 weeks. Thank you again for watching. Hope you enjoy. Bye.